As you might have already heard, system architect for PlayStation Mark Cerny had an interview with Wired about the next-gen PS5. While he didn't spill the beans on all of the specs, he did share quite a bit so we can approximate what the PS5 will be like. In this video, I want to dive deeper into what was talked about and maybe shed some light on some of the bold claims that were made. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, a quick message from our sponsor, Memory Express. They're based here in Canada and have a grand opening sale for the Victoria, BC store. The sale starts on April 26th online and 27th in store and will last through the 29th. Click on the link in the description for more info. All right, so the PS5. Let's start with the CPU. The processor will be a 3rd-gen Ryzen based on the Zen 2 architecture. It will have 8 cores and be built on the 7-nanometer process. As for the GPU, it will be a custom solution based on AMD's Navi. If we follow those Gonzalo leaks, the CPU could actually have SMT enabled for 8 cores and 16 threads. That's a lot of CPU. I wonder how the chip will be laid out though. So far, every time we saw Zen 2, like with the Epyc ROME CPU or Ryzen 3000, we had a chiplet system. So will the PS5 follow that route? Maybe we'll have the same thing that was rumored for the Ryzen 3000 series APUs, like one I/O die, one 8-core chiplet, and maybe one dedicated Navi chiplet. That would allow that Navi GPU to be bigger than on a single monolithic die. Anyways, moving on, Mark specified that this new console will have support for 8K graphics. Now the key word here is support. Don't get me wrong, I would love to see that happen, but the PS4 Pro can barely do 4K as is. On semi-intensive games, it can do 1800p with an upscale to 4K, and with demanding games, it does checkerboard rendering to 1800p and then upscales up to 4K. So native 8K graphics on the PS5, I don't think so. It has to be upscale. But there's nothing wrong with that. Checkerboard rendering and upscaling actually give very impressive results. At the very least, it might just do proper native 4K and maybe higher resolutions using other methods. We might even see support for higher refresh rates like on the Xbox One X. He also said that this next gen console will be capable of ray tracing, probably basic ray tracing effects, but he did mention that ray tracing could also be used for audio, which I honestly just never thought of and is quite genius. Having sound bounce around everywhere would definitely help with positional accuracy. He also said that the console would support 3D audio. He mentioned that the key to this new console is a super fast SSD that would come stock with the PS5. Now he showed a demo to Wired on how fast this SSD is, and he compared it to a PS4 Pro with an SSD. He said that the PS4 Pro with an SSD was around a third faster than one with a hard drive, whereas the PS5 was around 19 times faster. He even claimed that it has a raw bandwidth higher than any SSDs available for PCs. Well, here's what I think he's actually talking about. It's just a next-gen NVMe drive. Now you might say, but he said it will have a higher bandwidth than any blah blah blah, it's a next-gen NVMe. Currently, PCIe 3.0 has a maximum theoretical speed of around 3.9 gigabytes per second on 4 lanes, which is what most NVMe drives use. The fastest NVMe of today are quite close to that. For example, the Samsung 970 Pro is at 3.5 gigabytes per second. Go to PCIe 4.0 and the max theoretical speed of 4 lanes of PCIe 4.0 shoots up to 7.9 gigabytes per second. So you see, the raw bandwidth he's referring to is based on PCIe 4.0, which Zen 2 supports, but we just don't have it yet. It's no wonder that it's faster than a PS4 with an SSD, because the PS4 couldn't even go faster than SATA 3 speeds, which is around 600 megabytes per second. So don't worry, Zen 2 and those next-gen NVMEs will be on the PC before the PS5 comes out in 2020. It's still impressive that they're adding such cutting-edge hardware into the console though. And lastly, he talked about the PSVR, confirming that the current headset is compatible with the next-gen console, but he didn't want to go further into details of the next-gen PSVR. So what do you guys think about my observation around the chiplet design, the 8K support, and the SSD. I'd love to know what theories you guys might have, so leave them down below. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one.